not making a judgment here. I know there's a lot more than seven things that you do with a spreadsheet, but I can tell you in my experience, I think these items work better in Microsoft's desktop Excel product than they do on Google Sheets right now. The first one that I want to go over is splitting the view. So when you're working in a table of data, like the one that you're looking at right here, you may want to look at the top and the bottom at the same time. I may be changing numbers here and I want to see what it does to the totals at the bottom. So in Excel, you can just split it. Just do the split function. You can move these around a little bit to whatever makes sense. I'm going to double left click on this one to get rid of it. And now I can see the same spreadsheet in two views. So on the bottom, I'm going to scroll down. I'm going to be looking at this sum, but I'm going to be changing things up here. I can see both areas of the spreadsheet nice and easy. In Google Sheets, there is no option to split the view like this. So a similar option, which is available in Excel and kind of in Google Sheets, is to just use two windows. So I'm going to undo the split sheet. And then this will give me two completely independent windows, so I can view a different worksheet in each window. So in Excel, you have to do a new window and then a range window and then tell it which way, we'll say vertical. And then it puts these two windows right next to each other. I had a third one open apparently underneath. I'm going to close that one. That's how you do it in Excel. New window, arrange all, vertical. If I go back to Google Sheets, there is no view new. There's no view split. Can't do it. So what you have to do, I'm going to get out of full screen so you can see my browser and ignore this tab for now. This will come in later. What you need to do to give yourself a new window is just literally open up a new tab and navigate back to that spreadsheet. I'm just going to copy and paste here so you don't see me digging through my bookmarks. Okay, so you have that spreadsheet here. Pull it off. Just hold the left mouse button. Pull it off. Get rid of that. I'm going to hold my Windows key and hit right. I'm going to go to the old one, hold my Windows key and hit left. And then I have the same spreadsheet in two views. You can work independently in these. In the demonstration with what I was doing with the new window or with the split views, you can do here. So I can go down to the bottom. And if there's a total here, I can change a number over here and it's going to change that total. Let me make sure this is on your screen. Here's my total. At the end of the spreadsheet, I'm going to change this number here and that total is going to update live. So that's a pretty useful two windows version for you. Third thing that I feel like Excel is better at than Google Sheets, inserting special characters. This is especially helpful for auditors or accountants if you want to tick mark things. Say there's something special about this line here and you want to insert a symbol. Later on, you can define that symbol as whatever you want. I'm not going to show you how to use tick marks right now. That's a little outside the scope of this video, but that's how you insert special characters or symbols. If you go back to Google Sheets, if you want to insert a special character into Google Sheets, the workaround is to open up a Google Doc. There, do insert special character. Pick one that you want. Copy it. Go back to Google Sheets and paste it. There's your special character. You can make it red now and bold to use it as a tick mark. Not easy to do in Google Sheets. Easy to do in Excel. The next way that Excel is better is the option to just clear. For example, you can use clear in a couple different ways. I like to use it to clear formats. It might be off your screen right now. Let me tuck this in a little bit. This is the clear option. It's going to say clear on top of it if you have this on full screen probably. If you want to clear formats, say this whole thing, I don't want it blue anymore. I just want it to be regular default formatting. Just do clear formats. Gets rid of all that. I'm going to do Control Z to get rid of that to show you, hey, if I want to get rid of this and I want to get rid of the formatting, clear all. It's all gone. If you do type into it again, it's just default again. So that gets rid of everything. And it's different than the delete button. The delete button will just get rid of the text. It won't get rid of the text and the formatting. So clear provides you with a lot of flexibility to wipe out stuff quickly. To do that in Google Sheets, it's just not there. Bring this back over here. You can delete things, but you can't go in and just clear. If you had data and formatting, you'd have to delete the data and then reset all the formatting. Or you could select a cell that had default formatting, do the format painter, and paint the cell that you want to erase the formatting from. Another way I think Excel is better is the ability to just simply do a double bottom border. Accountants live on double bottom border. If this is a total, the standard to denote that would be to put a double bottom border on it. Or you could do a double underline, depending on your preference. I find the double underline in the format cells, double underline. If you go into Google Sheets and try to do that, it's not there. It can't be done. You can do a single bottom border, maybe. The workaround would be to insert a row below it and do another bottom border. And then you could tuck these in under each other. It's not the same thing though. There's an empty row there. It could trip you up if you add another number and you can barely see it. You won't even know it's there. This isn't the best. Well, if you're using Google Sheets, it's the only way to get a double underline. It's not the best practice though. There's a couple more nuances to doing a double underline. I have another video on it. How convenient. If you want to watch it, so go check that out. Another thing about Excel that's just easier is the printing. One of the things that Google Sheets is missing that I use all the time is just a page break preview. You just turn this on, yada yada. Let me zoom in a little bit for you, and you can see where your page breaks are going to be, and you can move them around. Nice and simple. If you only want one page and you don't want column G, you just do this. Google Sheets does not have that. Google Sheets has more options now than they used to. Such as you can take the grid lines off, you can include the titles, but you can't just do the page break preview. Another thing you also can't do is print with headers or footers, which a lot of people miss that in Google Sheets. The last thing that you can do in Excel, but you can't do in Google Sheets, is sort by highlighting. So it can be really useful in Excel. Say this list is huge, but a lot of it's highlighted. You can just go in and sort on cell color. And let's say we want to bring the yellow to the top. You can do that in Google Sheets. You can't do that. All I'm going to do is I'm going to show you that you can't do that. Sort sheet. And it just sorts it. It doesn't give you, it's not what we really wanted to do. It doesn't give you the option to pick any criteria. Even if you try filter and you go to the drop down arrow, you filter by values, it's not there. Condition. There's no highlighting in here. There's no cell is filled or not filled. Cell is a certain color. So that's my rundown of 7 things that I think work better in the desktop version of Excel. I'm using Microsoft Excel 2010. It's going to be really similar in 2013, 2016. So I think this will still be pertinent to you. I know there's a lot of things that Google Sheets does better, but not everything. So I hope you found that useful, and I'll talk to you again soon.